Hi, everybody. Dave Winder here, and here's what's coming up today on the Racer Report. The Racers open up with Campbellsville at home, the 41st season of football in Stewart Stadium. We'll have highlights. The Racers set the modern-day scoring record in the game, and we'll have post-game comments from some of the Racers players, and the first runs of the season from Racer 1. And this week, it's Family Weekend at Murray State, and Missouri State will be making a visit to Stewart Stadium. Plus today, the voice of the Racers, Neil Bradley, and his best calls. The Racer Report begins right now. Hi, folks, and welcome to the Racer Report with Head Coach Chris Hatcher, Dave Winder here, and let's get into Family Weekend and another home game for the Racers, back-to-back home games. Missouri State is coming in, 6 o'clock kick at Roy Stewart Stadium on Saturday, and we'll have a big crowd with Family Weekend. Hope that you'll make your plans to be there. Well, we're sitting here today. Coach, you got a big victory, 83-14 as Campbellsville came in. Racers played great. Your thoughts on a game that you actually shortened the fourth quarter to kind of get it over with, because it was over long before that.
First of all, 83-14 does not sound it sounds weird to me.
I know,
it sounds like
does.
A basketball score. That's the most points I've ever scored as a coach and as a player, and it's the most that in the modern day that Murray State scored. But great night for Racer football. We honored our seniors. Very touching moment. Those guys have been with me. There was three since I arrived. There were three that were holdovers from the previous staff that have made it 5 years of college football. So I'm very proud of those guys. We were in command from the first play on. We played a team that was of Campbellsville NAIA opponent. Mm-hmm. Very well coached. Had a lot of class, but we just had them outmanned at every position, and it showed. And we have a lot of great highlights. 41 points first quarter.
Right.
Pretty much says it all.
All right, so let's go ahead and roll it here and take a look at it. As we did mention, it was senior day as the Racers got into this today. You know, Coach, you changed it up and you went with honoring the seniors on the opening day, and that was a nice thing.
Well, traditionally, those are our biggest crowds, and we were able to honor those guys. It was a nice evening. It was just a good atmosphere for us. As you can see, we're taking the field, got our new uniforms, our Nike Pro Combat. The players love them, and they're light, and we come out of the gate, they're going to try one deep, and here you can see Brandon Wicks. Intercepts the football. He runs about 100 yards zigzagging across the field for probably about a 30-yard gain. But this kind of set the tone for the evening, and it was good to see us come out, play a team that we knew we were better than, and put them away early.
Well, you know, I heard you talk to your team on Friday evening, and you told them as a group, play to our level, play as good as we can play. And I thought you did that, Coach. First drive here, 6 plays, 35 yards. After the turnover, you guys punched it in with Brady.
Good catch there, Paul Rice, sophomore out of St. Louis, and did a nice job. And here's a second and short. Mikael Miller on the sprint out gets good blocking on the right side from Kamali Matthews. And Dwayne Brady, another senior, had a great day. Ended up having 4 touchdowns on the day. Picks up some valuable yards. But we could pretty much do what we wanted to do. Great protection here. Look, Mikael had all day. We get in scramble mode. Janowski Davis, he's trying to get in the end zone. I don't know that he scored a touchdown in his career, maybe one. And we get down here, and Brady makes a nice run over the right side. Big Robert Olive, 73. And then that was a punishing run by Dwayne to the one, and we're in our high-tempo mode here. He walks in. Excellent blocking on the perimeter to put us up 7-0 for the evening.
That was with 12:58 to go in the first quarter. Now move ahead to 8:13 in the first quarter. This is a 30, or you're going to see a 30-yard play with Miller to Powell to make it 13-0.
Good run after the catch by Jamal Berry, who played a good game. And then we come back, throw the screen backside, get an outstanding block on the corner, and Walter takes it in for his second touchdown of the season.
Is Walter the fastest receiver on the team? You guys ever, what is he in the 40?
I don't know what he runs in the 40. He can run. Pokey Harris is the fastest player on the team. That is documented. And then right here, Daryl Smith, senior out of Port St. Joe, Florida, comes up with the pick six. And Daryl has really been playing good here lately, and I'm mighty proud that he was able to make a big play on senior night.
Well, the Racers there scored two touchdowns in a span of about 11 seconds with that turnover. Then after the kickoff here, you guys are motoring again and getting it down the field.
Jeremy Harness, outstanding run after the catch, eludes a couple tacklers, races into the end zone. He was extremely excited. A good job. Again, we talk all the time with our players about getting upfield. He did an excellent job there.
And great to see Racer 1 going around the track. Brooklyn Jerpy, she is the first ever jockey from Murray, Kentucky, riding Racer 1. Glad to see them out there. And then, Coach, we're going to move into the late first quarter. This was just a blitz you put on Campbellsville here. It just hit them from every angle.
Well, you saw a good catch there by Pokey Harris, Walter Pyle. And what's allowing this to happen is our defense has been playing outstanding. They're getting a lot of three and outs. We're starting great field position. Their punter did not have a very good night. Jordan Morrow gets in on the catch. I know we have so many explosive plays that we have to show, but whenever you're able to score as many points as we did the other night, the defense has to be getting the ball back to the offense, and they played outstanding all night long.
And then Jamal Berry got into the act, 24-yard touchdown, made it 34-0, six plays, 68 yards for the Racers. It's one thing about defense, Coach, you know, the 2-yard tackle for a loss isn't the glamorous play that people show. But that's the whole thing about defense. You don't want them on the field. You need to get them off the field. Three plays and get out of there.
Well, that's their job.
Yeah,
and,
right.
And here's a great throw and a great dive and catch by Janowski Davis. Excellent run here by Dwayne Brady getting around the edge. Drew Kelly there, outstanding blocking. And here's a guy we're really excited about is Jesse Blackburn, big wide receiver from right outside of Birmingham, Alabama. He is a load to bring down. And then we get down close, and Dwayne Brady runs it in for a touchdown.
Yeah, the yardage, 262 to 44 after the first quarter. Racers up 41-0. By the way, that play by Janowski Davis, we sent that to ESPN, thought maybe he could get on the top 10. I don't think we made it, but that was you won't find a better catch on Saturday anywhere in the country than that one.
No, he laid out, gave up his body, and did a really nice job. But you can see we pretty much got manhandling the game is the word I like to use. And again, great blocking. Kamali Matthews ends up blocking three guys on the play. He's a right tackle outside of Atlanta, Georgia. And Brady goes in for another touchdown. And he didn't have a whole lot of yards on the night, but he made each and every one of them count.
Okay, so now move to 9:33 before the half. Little flip pass to Barry. He reversed field and got it back over for a big 26-yard gain. And then Janowski Davis caught an 11-yard ball, and then Walter Powell scored his second touchdown of the day.
We called him in man coverage, and we're getting ready to pull all of our ones out. We wanted to get a little bit more work, and we hit him on the post route. That's Walter's third of the season, second of the night. And, again, we're just scoring at will at this point. Here's their defense coming out. Again, they played great all night. There was just nowhere for them to go. We force another turnover, which was good to see. And I believe that was John Thorell who recovered the fumble. It's hard to see who forced the fumble.
Well, the official play-by-play said Felton Collins forced it. But either way, your defensive line was on the other side of the line of scrimmage there.
We got a really good pass rush all night. Mm-hmm. And I thought that those guys played a lot better than they did the first night. We had a couple busted coverages when we put a few of the backups in, but you know, for the most part, like Parks Frazier's in right here, and this is Dwayne's fourth touchdown of the evening. Great run. Dwayne's not a big guy, but he gets behind his pads. It was good to see our backups get a lot of action, and as we head into halftime, at this point, it was almost a two-hour first half.
And it was a long first half.
I'm thinking, God, we're going to be here 4 or 5 hours. And
right.
Fortunately for us, we were able to shorten the second half time-wise. But you're up 62-14. That's a pretty good half of football if you're on the 62 side.
Right, no matter how you cut it. 62-14, that's the first half with head coach Chris Hatcher. We'll see you the second half here in just a moment on the Racer Report.
We'll be right back. Like the thoroughbreds we are named for, racers are spirited and proud. We have the heart and will to succeed, to go farther, learn more, and embrace wisdom. We are champions who take our place in the Murray State tradition. We are racers.
Enough of this golf already.
How much of the golf?
Golf's stupid.
You're stupid.
Boys, settle down. At Time Warner Cable, any of these devices can be your TV at the click of a button. No one offers more sports on more devices than Time Warner Cable.
Why have you got a laptop?
I want the cell phone.
Give me that laptop.
Call 1-855-WANT-TWC and ask how you can save up to $600. Switch to a better entertainment experience guaranteed. Time Warner Cable. Enjoy better.
Roof Brothers, a Paducah tradition for 100 years. Roof Brothers, locally owned, family run. Roof Brothers, the best selection of beer, wine, and spirits found anywhere. Roof Brothers, service from selecting that special beverage for that special occasion to a keg party at the lake. Roof Brothers, two locations to serve you. Roof Brothers, proud supporters of Murray State Athletics.
Hi, folks. Welcome back to segment two of the Racer Report with head coach Chris Hatcher. Dave Winder here. We're going to roll the tape and take a look at the second half as the Racers went into the halftime locker room up 62-14. So, coach, what did you say to your team? The game's in hand. What did you want to work on in the second half?
Well, we wanted to make sure our guys were focused and go out there and continue to work on the things that we practice, no matter who took the field. And we come out, execute our kickoff return extremely well. Pokey Harris gets good blocking. Josh Brown, nice little pickup on the sideline. At this point, we have all of our backups. And one guy I'd like to mention, Marcus Holiday, 24. He actually had 18 rushes, I think, for 132 yards, mm-hmm. two touchdowns on the night. He is a redshirt freshman. We're really high on him, and he came in, played great. Our offensive line, they blocked well, and it was just good to see our backups go out there and execute the game plan. They practice too, and they're good boys, and it was valuable experience for them. And here we get a fourth and long situation, great protection for Parks Frazier, and he hits Jesse Blackburn for his first career touchdown pass, and also his first career touchdown reception. Then Mark Weinstra came in for Jordan Bitten and knocks it on through.
And there you see Racer 1. Racer 1 was a little unsure about his first couple of runs down the front stretch, but he got it figured out, and we're really glad for that. Coach, you know, when you think about it, you know, in college football, the backups are just one play from being in there, and they've got to be ready.
No doubt. And you know, we don't have a whole bunch of backups. Mm-hmm. I mean, we when you get past the twos, we don't have a whole lot of threes in there. So they started getting a little winded, and so we had to put a few starters back in every now and then to keep the rotation. But we had some guys make some good plays. William Higginson out of Mayfield made a good play on the kickoff a little while ago. We do a good job here. Jonowski Davis filling in for Walter Powell does a good job of the fair catch. And here's Marcus Holiday. You can tell why I'm excited about
right.
the young man. He's a hard runner. He's out of Memphis, Tennessee, and he was extreme. He was tired, but he was extremely excited. And here's his second touchdown of the evening. At this point, I laugh, Dave, because he had to be exhausted. That's the most he's run the football since he's been a racer.
Well, you know, this was pretty much, Coach, what you wanted to get out of it. You wanted your offense to play at a high level. You wanted your defense to play at a high level, and I think you accomplished that in this game.
We did, and now we talk about each week. I really never talk about the opponent to the team. I talk about us being the best that we can possibly be, and that was what I was more proud of with our guys. We came out. We played as we tried to play as good as we could. We beat an opponent that we should have beaten, and we took care of them early, and that's always good to see.
Okay, class act there too. Coach Thomas from Campbellsville, former Tillman coach. Good to see him on Saturday night as well. So we'll take a break here, come back with some of the post-game comments. We'll do that next on the Racer Report.
Roof Brothers, a Paducah tradition for 100 years. Roof Brothers, locally owned, family run. Roof Brothers, the best selection of beer, wine, and spirits found anywhere. Roof Brothers, service from selecting that special beverage for that special occasion a keg party at the lake. Roof Brothers, two locations to serve you. Roof Brothers, proud supporters of Murray State Athletics.
Enough of this golf already.
How much of the golf?
Golf's stupid.
You're stupid.
Boys, settle down. At Time Warner Cable, any of these devices can be your TV at the click of a button. No one offers more sports on more devices than Time Warner Cable.
Why, have you got a laptop?
I want the cell phone.
Give me that laptop.
Call 1-855-WANT-TWC and ask how you can save up to $600. Switch to a better entertainment experience, guaranteed. Time Warner Cable. Enjoy better.
I go because my friends are here.
I go because it's so close.
I go
for the small class sizes.
I go
to get a better job.
I go because I can take classes when it works for me.
I go because I can transfer my credits.
I go for some of Kentucky's most affordable tuition.
I go because it's crazy not to.
For all the right reasons. The Kentucky Community and Technical College System. Higher education begins here.
Doing? It's summer. Let's hit the beach.
Mom?
You need a Pepsi.
Ooh. Mm.
Let's have some fun.
Woo! All right.
Summertime is Pepsi time. You got to work on that tan, bro.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back to the Racer Report with head coach Chris Hatcher. Coach will join us again in just a moment. But it was Senior Day Saturday as the Racers played their season opener, our home opener, against the Campbellsville Tigers. It was a great day. A lot of families there to honor our seniors. There were 22 of them. And Darryl Smith, one of our defensive backs, he talked about it being a big senior day after the game.
Oh, this is a dream come true. I never thought we'd put up plenty of points like that. But we came out real focused. Coach has always been talking the whole week about being focused and stuff. So we had to let the seniors know we really care about y'all. We're going to send y'all out with a victory.
One. There's Darryl Smith along with Dwayne Brady and Chavez Sims in the postgame press conference. But, yeah, Darryl made a great point there. They've been through the wars with you. They were really glad to have senior night on opening night. I think it was a special night for them.
I think so. They seemed to enjoy it. It's something new. It was a bigger crowd, a little better atmosphere, possibly than later in the year. And of course, when you win, it makes everything that much better.
Yeah, certainly so. Do you know what, though? I think it was 22 seniors, or was it 21? One of the two. I don't remember exactly, but this group sticks together. You could have a special season here as you keep building week by week.
I think we can. I'm excited about what the future holds for this football team. I think we're more athletic. We got better overall team speed. We play with a little bit more of an edge about ourselves. And we enjoy competing. And the big thing with our team is we got just to learn to practice hard every day during the week. And that's something that we lacked during Missouri, that we lacked it versus Campbellsville. We always have one day where there's a little lull. We got to have great practices each and every day. And that's something we're striving as a football team. And as coaches, we have not let up on the guys whatsoever. Because as we move forward, we're going to start playing competition at our level, and that's when the season really begins.
Well, that's what we'll talk about on the other side of the break. The big game this week, Missouri State coming in. It's family weekend, and we'll have a great crowd there. I want you to be part of it as the Racers take on the Bears. We'll talk more about that. We'll do that next here on the Race Report with head coach Chris Hatcher.
I go because my friends are here.
I go because it's so close.
I go
for the small class sizes.
I go
to get a better job.
I go because
I can take classes when it works for me.
I go because I can transfer my credits.
I go for some of Kentucky's most affordable tuition.
I go because it's crazy not to.
For all the right reasons. The Kentucky Community and Technical College System. Higher education begins here.
Hey, ladies. Enjoying the film? Of course not. Because this is our movie! And Dr. Pepper 10 is our soda. It's only 10 manly calories, but with all 23 flavors of Dr. Pepper, it's what guys want, like this!
Hey,
catchphrase.
So you can keep the romantic comedies and lady drinks. We're good.
Dr. Pepper 10, it's not for women!
10 seconds to go. Harper coming forward. Moves in top of the key. 6 seconds to go. The three.
Enough of this golf already.
How much of the golf?
I'm stupid.
You're stupid.
Boys, settle down. At Time Warner Cable, any of these devices can be your TV at the click of a button. No one offers more sports on more devices than Time Warner Cable.
Why, have you got the laptop?
I want the cell phone.
Give me that laptop.
Call 1-855-WANT-TWC and ask how you can save up to $600. Switch to a better entertainment experience guaranteed. Time Warner Cable. Enjoy better.
3-2-1. Back here in the Racer Report with head coach Chris Hatcher. Don't forget, it's family weekend at Murray State, and the big game Saturday is Missouri State coming in at 6 o'clock. And, coach, you're looking at their game at Iowa Saturday, 28-14 loss. There was a period in that game where it was 21-0, and they kind of did the same thing that you did against Campbellsville. Touchdown, quick turnover, another touchdown, and they were right back in that ball game. And Terry Allen's club, they've much improved, aren't they?
They played an outstanding game against Iowa, and I know Iowa struggled a little bit. What I was hoping, the game would be close and they'd have to play their guys the full time, and I haven't gotten to that point of the film yet, but they played them well. They had a tough first game against Northwestern State, which is a good football team, very close game. Both of the times that we've played them the past couple years have been, come right down to the very end, been very close games. So this is our first FCS opponent that we will play all season. The first two games were more like preseason. You go on the road, you play Missouri. You come home, you play a Campbellsville team that we were able to take care of pretty quickly. This will be our first big test of the year, if you will, when it comes to playing level, our competition level.
Of course, the 83 points by Murray State against Campbellsville broke the record of the 72. Of course, that amazing game from 2010. And it kind of brought back, oh, we're playing Missouri State this week. They're from a great conference.
Well,
maybe the best, probably the best conference in our division.
They're one of them.
Yeah.
And you know, you get, if you have playoff aspirations later on in the season, it always looks good to have defeated an opponent from another conference. So that certainly plays into it. But again, at the end of the day, no matter whom the opponent is, our goal is to play the very best that we can play, prepare to the very best of our abilities. We will treat this week no differently than we have the previous two. However, I expect our focus to be a little sharper this week because the guys know what we're getting ourselves into.
That's right. From here on out, big games for the Racers. We'll take another break. Our final break here at the Racer Report. We'll come back and wrap it up with Coach.
Enough of this golf already.
How much of the golf?
I'm stupid.
You're stupid.
Boys, settle down. At Time Warner Cable, any of these devices can be your TV at the click of a button. No one offers more sports on more devices than Time Warner Cable.
Why, have you got a laptop?
I want the cell phone.
Give me that laptop.
Call 1-855-WANT-TWC and ask how you can save up to $600. Switch to a better entertainment experience guaranteed. Time Warner Cable. Enjoy better.
Roof Brothers, a Paducah tradition for 100 years. Roof Brothers, locally owned, family run. Roof Brothers, the best selection of beer, wine, and spirits found anywhere. Roof Brothers, service from selecting that special beverage for that special occasion to a keg party at the lake. Roof Brothers, two locations to serve you. Roof Brothers, proud supporters of Murray State Athletics.
seconds to go.
Harper coming forward. Moves in top of the key. 6 seconds to go. The three.
Two, one. Hi, folks. Back here to wrap it up with head coach Chris Hatcher on the Racer Report. Don't forget, the next game's a home one. It's Saturday, 6 o'clock against Missouri State's family weekend. And, coach, it was a fantastic time for me. You came out to the stadium early, and you could smell the barbecue, and you could see the smoke rising over in the tailgate area. We need a big crowd Saturday night, and folks, come on out and have a lot of fun. Bring your food and tailgate and have a good time with it.
We definitely do. I mean, this is a big game, and there's make no bones about it, and I appreciate the folks who came out to the ball game Saturday against Campbellsville. Had a lot of fraternity and sororities out there in the parking lot, which is good to see the school spirit. What better things can you do on a Saturday in the fall than go watch the Racers play? And we need a big crowd supporting us. I hope that we get it. And we need to have a great week of preparation. Again, I've said it 3 or 4 times on the show tonight. This is a big game for the Racers.
All right, Coach. So we'll let you get to work then.
Thank you, Dave.
Okay, Head Coach Chris Hatcher, we'll see you next time on the Racer Report. As we leave you today, here's the voice of the Racers, Neil Bradley.
Third and inches. This time Brady will waltz into the end zone off tackle left side. The Racers are on the board at the 13:04 mark on an official 1 yard run from Brady at 6-0. Man in motion is Barry. Miller instead turns right side. It comes to Powell. Powell at the 20, 10, 15, or 5, and into the end zone. Powell goes all the way for the score. Under center, it's fumbled. Quarterback does a great job recovering, throws, and it's picked off. Pick six, 10, 5, touchdown, Racers. Darryl Smith with the pick and the score. It's 19-0, but that was all caused by the pressure on the game. To his right, Miller with a two-step drop. Looks across the middle, has his man. It's caught by Morrill out across the 40, 30, slips a man, 25, 20, 15, 10, and that's Harness, who dives into the end zone for the touchdown. The ball popped loose, but it's too late. Jeremy Harness with the catch and the touchdown. It's 26-0. Missouri State. The 25, handoff goes to Barry. He's across the 20, 15, makes a cut. He's at the 10, 5, goodbye. Jamal Barry with a touchdown, and the Racers on the board with 3:09 to go. It's 33-0. Miller looks for the deep ball, has a man, diving play. He goes down at the 20 and dives to the 18. Janowski Davis with an amazing catch. Stretch play goes to Brady. Brady's got some room. He's across the 40, 35, 30. He may take it. 20, 15, 10, 5. Touchdown Racers. 54 yards on the play. Brady's third touchdown of the game. Shotgun. Barry stands to his right. Looks across the middle, floats it into the end zone. Walter Powell with the grab, his second touchdown of the night. And the Racers put 6 more on the board. It's 54-0.